Sports City, Sports City, Chef, Chef. Sports City, Sports City, Chef, Chef. Yeah. Cavi, Taj.
Yes, yes, yes. This is The Villain. Thank you for listening to the Finger Foods edition on the YouTube channel of the Sports City Chefs, exclusively on the YouTube channel of Sports City Chefs. If you like what you see or you like what you hear, please hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and you'll get more content from us. We're posting content every day. We got Finger Foods, we got the Poo Poo Platter, and we got the Lunch Break. We got a lot of things popping. So let's get to it. And first, let me get into the New York Giants and our week 3 loss to the Atlanta Falcons. Mr. Mara, John Mara, let me talk to you for a second. Step into my room real quick. Listen, we're suffering Giant fans right now. I know you heard the boos. I know you heard the fans at the Eli Manning ceremony booing you. Boos weren't for you. The boos were for this organization. 5 straight years, 0-2 start, now 0-3 for the second straight year under Joe Judge. It's unacceptable. Are you for real? I mean, are we for real right now? 4-time Super Bowl champions. Countless NFL championships. Bill Parcells, Lawrence Taylor, Art Sherman, Frank Gifford. And now we got another 0-3 start. Haven't been to the playoff once in 10 years. Another losing season on the way. One playoff game in 10 years, a loss since the Super Bowl in 2011. We're tired of this. We want to win. We're tired of losing. We don't want to do this no more. We pay the PSLs. We go to the stadium. We watch the games. We support our team, Big Blue. We want a winner. We don't want losers. We got to do something about this, John. We got to fix this. If it's Gettleman, if it's Judge, if it's the personnel, I don't know what it is. We got to fix this. This is unacceptable. We're tired. We're tired, John. I know you're tired. We tired, too. All right, I had to do that. I had to get into my soapbox because it's getting a little bit frustrating. The Giants lost in the last second again against the Atlanta Falcons. Took a 17-14 loss. Giants lost on a last-second field goal by Young Ho Koo. A 40-yard field goal as time expired, and the Giants fall to 0-3 in a game that they probably should have won and probably was their best chance to win in a while. I'll start with some of the good, and then I'll get right to the bad. I mean, one of the good things that you can say in this game, Daniel Jones, another game, another really mistake-free football. I think if you had question marks about Daniel Jones going into the season and how he would perform starting this season, I think he's answered the questions. Only one turnover in his first 3 games, through no interceptions, no touchdowns. I had a stack with Daniel Jones and Saquon Barkley. I really thought those two were going to have a nice game against a defense that got lit up the last 2 weeks against the Eagles and against the Buccaneers, and you know, the stack didn't work. Saquon did score a touchdown, his first touchdown in almost 2 years, but you know, Daniel Jones threw for 266 yards, but I mean, it wasn't really much else to kind of write home about. Rushed for another 39 yards. I like him on fantasy. I wrote about it in our waiver wire pickups. I think he's a solid pickup. If you don't get him now, you might not ever get him. But you know, Daniel Jones has been playing well so far this year. You know, taking care of the football. I think there's some things he needs to clean up, staring down receivers, not going through his progression. But not going through his progression really has to do with the offensive line. The offensive line, first half, I thought played pretty well. Second half, kind of got pushed around, and the Atlanta Falcons front really got after. Daniel Jones, got some quarterback hits. Grady Jarrett looked like a superstar against them, and really getting some hits. Dante Fowler as well. So I think that's some things they have to clean up. Another thing I kind of want to allude to in this game, Azeez Ojulari needs to play. This kid needs to start. I mean, listen, I know he's raw. I know, you know, he's a second round pick, and they got two guys in front of him that, you know, have been here for a year or two. But when he's on the field, he starts to make plays. I think he gets on the field on third downs. And you know what? He's quick off the ball. And he's pretty much the only edge pass rusher that you can see with your naked eye that can really make plays. He's had a sack in every game so far this season. The first Giant to have a sack in his first three games. I mean, and this is, we're talking about a team that's had one of the greatest pass rusher ever in Lawrence Taylor. But then you go to Strahan, Tuck, JPP, OC, you know, the list goes on and on of guys that they've run through here in defensive linemen. And, you know, he's in elite company with those guys already. So, listen, I think for the most part, the defense played pretty well. They showed up. I think after the first two games where they didn't really play very well, I thought they had a good game. They had a good game plan. They really took Pitts out of the game until late in the fourth quarter. I think they left Ridley open a little bit, but I think that was a part of the scheme. They frustrated Matt Ryan. I think he was looking downfield a lot and then checked it down underneath to Cordell Patterson, who had some nice catches and went for about 82 yards passing because of underneath stuff. So the defense played well, you know, but I mean, in the fourth quarter, they let up those 10 unanswered points. You know, that long touchdown drive and then the field goal to win the game. Okay, here's my problem with the Giants right now. The mistakes are killing the Giants, and this is the third game that we're just seeing mistake after mistake after mistake. Either they're killing themselves with missed tackles, they're killing themselves with penalties, communication errors in the secondary. You know, whatever they can do to plague themselves and kill themselves with mental mistakes, they're doing right now. You know, listen, Joe Judge, I like him as a coach, but when he came in here, it was all about discipline and you know, alleviating the mental mistake, all that good stuff. And I see a team that has gotten worse with that. Okay, we're talking about you didn't have as much talent as you did. You know, this year you have more talent than you did last year. You were able to attract talent, but now you've got them in here and you're still making mistakes. If not, you're making more mistakes. So that's pointing to the coaching. I like to kill Jason Garrett for his lack of creativity. I mean, he doesn't get a pass here, but I mean, the mental mistakes are killing them more than anything else. I mean, we're talking mismanagement of timeouts in the second half. I mean, blowing timeouts, letting the play clock get to zero, or not being able to get the defensive call right. Now, listen, losing Blake Martinez is part of that, and we'll get to that later. But mental mistakes are killing this Giants team. Challenging a touchdown last week against the Washington football team. You know, penalties that are knocking you out of drives that, you know, sustained drives. Listen, the Giants moved the ball well in the first half, but now you're talking about 8 penalties in this game for 53 yards. The first half, Giants are driving. What happens in the red zone? Stalled because of mental mistakes. I mean, the first time Daniel Jones was, you know, basically getting sacked because of a missed block. You know what I mean? A lot of missed blocks stopping Saquon Barkley at the line of scrimmage. You know, momentum killing drives where, you know, they're the first two drives should have got touchdowns. They got him called back. You know, they got to move the ball back because of a false start penalty or a sack, and then they had to settle for field goals. And once it was 6-0, I knew that's only one score. They can come right down the field, the Falcons, and get those points back. I mean, Xavier McKinney, the safety for the Giants, was flagged for a personal foul when he made a hit on the wide receiver, And you know, they said he was out of bounds. He was still kind of making a move, sort of inbounds, but you got to learn to ease up. You know what I mean? So that was a killer. I mean, you're talking about a fumble by our favorite tight end, Evan Ingram, who was playing his first game after the calf injury and who was electric on the field. But then now you're talking about inside of 2 minutes, Giants are starting to move the ball and possibly move in, at least get a field goal. Go into the half and then get the ball back in the second half. What happens on his play? He fumbles. The ball gets knocked out, and the Giants held. The defense held on that. Didn't allow points, but I mean, it was a momentum killing drive. And then obviously the interception, dropped interception by Adoree' Jackson in the end zone was a killer because that would have stopped the drive, under 5 minutes to go in the game. Now they got a touchdown right after that. And it's easy to say that that play would have been the game still, but I'm thinking last week where Bradberry was getting abused by McLaurin all day, and then makes a terrific interception, and that should have sealed the game last week. Go three and out, settle for a field goal. The Washington football comes right back down the field and wins the game. I don't know if that interception would have changed the momentum. They probably would have got the ball back with maybe 2 minutes left in the game and still would have had time to move the ball down the field. Who knows? The way the offense was moving for the Giants. So, listen, it's just, you know, a drop here by Evan Ingram, a penalty against Will Hernandez on the opening play to a screen pass, a nice play to Saquon Barkley that negates a 20-yard gain. You know, drop touchdown pass for a wide open CJ Bard, you know, that would have taken him out of the shadow of the end zone. Then you got a second and long and then a third and long. All these mistakes are starting to pile up. And when you're an 0-2, now an 0-3 team, mistakes like this are killing you. So, I mean, that's on the coach. He's got to clean it up. He could say whatever he wants in post game, but if you can't coach a disciplined team, then what are we talking about here? And then injuries, you know, starting to bite us in the butt. I mean, losing Blake Martinez on the second or third play of the game was a killer. I mean, Mike Garafolo confirmed that, you know, he is out for the season with a torn ACL. Prayers up for Blake Martinez, the leader on the team, the leader on the tacklers too last year. So non-contact play. As soon as he went down, I knew it was an ACL, and then it was confirmed. So prayers up to him. But then losing Sterling Shepard and Darius Slayton both to hamstring injuries, they didn't really have. They weren't effective. I don't think they returned to the game. Kenny Galladay was already hurt. He was a game time decision. Worked out in pregame. I saw the pregame workout. Didn't look too crisp in his cuts, but I guess they thought, you know, maybe he could play, maybe be on a pitch count. But then he had to play a little bit more because they had really nobody out there outside of Evan and Ingram and Saquon. So, but you would see him for periods of time on the bike trying to keep his hip loose or you know, get himself going. So, injuries are starting to mount. You know, got something we got to watch out for. But I mean, 0-3 on Eli Manning Day, what else can you do to screw over Eli Manning? I mean, just to ruin his day. Listen, I felt bad that John Mara got booed during the ceremony. And I don't think it was directed at John Mara because, you know, listen, I think he is a really good owner. But I think the message was loud and clear that Giants fans are fed up. We're tired of this. I'm a Giant fan lifelong. It's hard for me. And everybody that knows me knows my babies. It's hard to me to tell them that we're Giant fans to watch this kind of nonsense. It's hard to justify it to my kids. You know, it's like lying about Santa Claus. Okay. I mean, we're the Giants. We shouldn't, this isn't, we've had enough. We've had enough of the losing. People are not going to show up to the stadium, not going to pay these PSLs, what have you, to get out there and watch this disgrace of a team right now that's not playing well. Now, things can change. I'm a believer, but listen, we've had enough. And you know what? If things don't change, heads got to roll. And everybody wants to point to Dave Gettleman. That's the logical place to start. He has made some good draft picks, But the things that he needed to fix the most, the offensive line, he hasn't done. He brought in the weapons. He made the risk using the number two pick on a running back. Drafted Daniel Jones too high. Maybe that might pay off. Who knows? But a lot of the picks that he has are misses. And you can't have a lot of misses as a GM. So we'll see. But now it doesn't get any easier. Listen, we thought – you didn't really think, but you would have considered the first – three games of the season to be, you know, where you can, you know, maybe get above 500 and start feeling good about yourself. Now you're talking about a stretch where they got to play the Saints, the Cowboys, the Rams, the Panthers, the Chiefs, and the Raiders before we get a bye week in week 10. Do you see a win in there? I don't. I mean, I see teams that we might be able to score on, that we might be able to do well on, but I also see games where we might not even be competitive. So, you know what? This is the NFL. It's time to get it moving. Time to get this train going in the right direction. And we're done. We're tired of it. So, that's all I got. Listen, I want to thank everybody for listening. Listen to me rant. Check us out, Sports City Chefs, the NFL Free-For-All. The baseball buffet on Thursdays. We got the Carlos Cookout on Wednesdays. The college tailgate is coming back. Look out for that on Saturdays. And you also have our flagship show, the Timeless Sunday Brunch. Like I said, please subscribe. Hit the like button. Comment if you want. That only just gives you more great content from the chefs. We got more coming. And on that note, tell a friend to tell a friend. It's the chefs again. And if they don't know, now you know. Thanks, guys. Talk to you next week. Sports City, Sports City, Chef, you, Chef, you. Sports City, Sports City, Chef, you, Chef, you. Yeah. Cabby. Taj.